One, two, three, go! Hello dear friends, once again, this is your Senior Citizen Blogger, Apo Gabay Knowledge Channel. Before I will discuss on my blog number 14, the first issue of the Filipino series by Banco Central ng Pilipinas. I'd like to say thank you to all my friends, new subscribers of the Apo Gabay Knowledge Channel. My dear friends, here is the contents of my blog number 14, the first issue of the Filipino series issued in 1969. As they don't have a year date printed on each note of our Banco Central issues or on the Filipino series, we can see the issued notes on the dated notes on the standard catalog of world paper money. In 1969, President Ferdinand Marcos ended up the issuing of the English series banknotes and issued the new Banco Central Filipino series. And there are 6 denominations of this series, from 1 peso, 5 pesos, 10 pesos, 20 pesos, 50 pesos, and 100 pesos, or the sangdaang piso. There is a one full set of these issued notes in 1969, the full complete set signed by President Ferdinand Marcos and Banco Central Governor Alfonso Calalang. But in this topic, I will show you the mixed signature of Governor of the Central Bank Alfonso Calalang and Gregorio Licaros. So we will start with the lower denomination, the piso or the 1 peso Filipino series. As you can see, the top heading now, instead of Central Bank of the Philippines, now written in Filipino, Republika ng Pilipinas, with the portrait of our national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal, on the left side, the seal of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas, which is the Type 2 bank seal, and also bearing the signature of President Ferdinand Marcos and Alfonso Calalang. The white circle, as you can see on the right side of the note, is the watermark area. If we raise the notes in the lighted area, we can see that's the same figure of Dr. Rizal in the watermark area. And this is the reverse side of the notes, showing the Declaration of Independence on June 12, 1898, on the Aguinaldo Mansion, the province of Cavite, followed by the 5 piso denomination, the portrait of Andres Bonifacio on the left, and also, as you see, the bank seal. There's changes on the bank seal of the Central Bank or the Banco Central seal number 3, also bearing the signature of President Ferdinand Marcos and Alfonso Calalang. Also, the letter A, prefix letter, signifies the early issued of this note. And this is the reverse side of the 5 piso. In the center is the signing of new members of the Katipunan, which is signing their membership in their own blood. Also in this issue, we can see the new isometrical design of the back end, obverse, and the reverse side of the note, followed by the 10 piso, which also the bank seal is the same, and also bearing the signature of President Ferdinand Marcos and Banco Central Governor Alfonso Calalang. The top heading is just the same, Republika ng Pilipinas, written in double outline. Also, you can see the letter A, prefix letter, signifies the early issued of this note. On the reverse side of this note, you see the Barasowing charts in the province of Bulacan, followed by 20 piso or the 20 pesos with the same bank seal, the same signature of President Ferdinand Marcos and Alfonso Calalang. And on the left side is the portrait of President Manuel L. Quezon. Also, the prefix letter is letter A, and the serial numbers are semi-solid numbers. The reverse side of this note is the picture of the Malacanang Palace in the center. The new isometrical design of this banknote. Next is followed by the 50 piso, which now, as you can see, the Banco Central seal is in the upper right side of the note. And this one is bearing the signature of President Ferdinand Marcos and Gregorio Licaros, Banco Central Governor. You notice the prefix letter is letter R and the serial number is 97, a lower digit serial number. The top heading also, the Republica na Pilipinas, also written in double outline, and the watermark area on the right side of the note. On the reverse side of this note, we could see the Batasan building at the center, the watermark area, and the three denominations of 50 on three corners and on the top heading of the note. And now, to complete the Pino series, here is the 100 pesos or the sandaang piso. The portrait of President Manuel Rojas and also bearing the signature of President Ferdinand Marcos and the Banco Central Governor Alfonso Calalang. The Banco Central seal now is in the left side. The same top heading, Republica ng Pilipinas, written in double outline. The prefix letter of this note is also letter A. And also, if you notice, the serial numbers is very close to a radar serial number. And this is the reverse side of the note, showing the old Central Bank building and the four denominations of 100 in four corners. So, my dear friends, here is the 6 pieces denomination and the first issue of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas. On behalf of Apo Jabay Knowledge Channel, once again, I would like to say thank you to all of you. Continued watching my videos. Subscribe, likes, share, comments, push the bell button to keep you updated on my next videos. I hope on behalf of my blogs that I'm sharing to you the currencies of the Philippines or the old currencies of the Philippines, you will gain more knowledge and you learn more about the significant and the many different signatures of our beautiful currencies in the Philippines. Before I will finish this video, I would like to shout out my grandchildren, Haley Cortea Medina and Chester Tete Medina. Also, my grandchildren, Sean Kobe Maliwat and Sean Jaron Maliwat. I would like to shout out to the youngest follower and viewer of Apo Jabay Knowledge Channel. Shout out to Norman Saku Garcia. Or I hope that you are the future numismatist someday. Keep safe, everyone, and God bless all of you.